Over the course of last year, I worked hard to bring about change in Hougang. When I realized that many people needed legal help, marital issues, financial problems, and when unable to afford legal service, I did not complain that why did the government not provide legal service. I called up my friend Subhas Ananda. And Subhas said, while you called me, you needed help, I'm here. On 15th of May, he came and we delivered that service. When the needy and the elderly highlighted their medical and disability needs, I arranged for the TCM consultations, $1 for $1, subsidized their health care, upgraded the toilets to be more elderly friendly. For families finding it hard to make ends meet, I helped them with health care and transport. A pilot program to help children to get better PSLE grades has now been converted into a full-fledged program. And you can trust me, there will be more to come. I was disappointed when I heard that some people said that it was easy for me to find money to fund my schemes. Money doesn't drop from the sky. And many of you have known that. Even the 4D store or shop Toto will not give you money so easily. I work hard to raise funds from many private donors, sponsors, and businesses. I pushed for government-funded schemes to be fast-tracked at Hougang. I also work with charitable organizations on projects to benefit the residents. But somehow, someone yesterday thought that it was wrong for me to have done so. Do you think I should continue helping the people? Do you think people need help? Do you think more should be done? I'm not going to stop in my approach and my direction. This is what I have set out to do, and this is what I'll continue. No matter what they say on the 22nd or on the 24th, it's the same. I will persist in helping the residents of Hougang. I have met many, many Hougang residents over the last 15 months from all walks of life. Many of you, I see many familiar faces in front of me today. My aunties and stuff are all there. Give them a cheer, my friend. These are wonderful people. I want to thank you guys for being here with me. Thank you for sharing with me your concerns, your hopes, your fears, and your dreams with me. I want you to know that I hear you. And I have and will continue to champion your concerns, your hopes, and your dreams. I know that there are things that you worry about daily. And you only know when you help people. When you sit down with them and you talk to them and you feel that fear and you feel that concern, and you work your socks off to take that part of the problem away from them. I can never solve all your problems, but I promise to share your pain. This is my promise to you. Thank you. I know that you worry about jobs. I know you worry about healthcare, cost of living, raising your children, retirement, and old age. Now, the government is working on these issues. DPM2 has said very affirmatively the government is committed to doing so. And I promise, even though DPM2 is a wonderful mentor of mine, I will continue to pressure him to do more. Let's go! Workers' Party, they are very confident that I will continue my work, regardless of the outcome of this by-election. I would like to thank them for their kind endorsement. Thank you so much for having this faith in me. I will do so. The question is, would they do the same for you, residents of Hougang? Let's get to the heart of what this election is about. This election, it is about you, my Hougang residents, my brothers and sisters. This is what this election is about. It is about you exercising your free choice again to choose that one person who best serves the needs of this community, this very ground that you are part of. Hougang belongs to you. Hougang can never be taken away from you. Hougang doesn't belong to the Workers' Party. Neither does it belong to the PAP. It belongs to the residents of Hougang. Only you will have the power to decide who will best take care of you for the long term. It is within your power and your free choice to decide who can best identify with your hopes, concerns, and dreams. I have a vision for Hougang. My vision is for Hougang that is truly cared for, where you can leave your children in good hands, while you work worry-free, where the elderly can enjoy their retirement with meaningful activities and access to good facilities, where low-income families can get help when they need it, where we can harness the energy of our youths and let them grow to become successful and fulfilled young adults. Where people can walk from block to block, from block to your bus station without getting soaked in the rain. Where your MP does more than just make grand speeches. My brothers and sisters, my residents of Hougang, remember, they are choosing more than a voice in Parliament. That is the easy part. It is also not about who can run the town council more effectively. Running it properly and taking care of basic needs, that is a given. You're choosing someone to deliver solutions to problems, not just talk about them. You want somebody with youthful energy to see things through. And I think I have that in abundance. Thank you. But I still believe in one thing, that you must have someone who is committed to the long-term good of Hougang. If I'm elected to be MP, I will raise your key concerns: inflation, healthcare, education, to government, and of course to Mr. Teo Chee Hin, DPM behind, and fight for issues close to your heart and mine too. I feel strongly about the incomes of low-wage workers. Much more needs to be done. The government can take the lead by ensuring better contracts with better employment terms. I feel strongly about helping families. I got married last year. And, don't speculate. There's no child coming in, you know. I got to work harder at that. I don't need that. I'm quite strong, my friend. I'm all right. But one thing they were to seriously consider about when we talk about fertility and stuff like that, it's easy to say that, you know, raise fertility. Some resident told me, raise facility, then you just do a power outage, you know. Population will go up. That is not the way the voice sings in Parliament. What is the effective choice? And one thing that is close to my heart, insurance for unborn children. When the ladies are pregnant, and the fathers as well, you'll be worried. You will be worried if something will happen to your kid. And you want to make sure that they're taken care of. This is close to my heart, and I'll fight for it. We should have better support for working parents, such as providing more dedicated spaces for childcare so that rental can be controlled and savings passed on to parents. I feel strongly about helping the elderly. They should not be left to fend on their own. Healthcare costs worries them, especially outpatient fees. We must do more for them. I feel strongly about helping and engaging the youth so that they can be a part of the new Hougang. They have a voice, they have the energy. And I see all these young men in front of me. Now these boys here and all you guys here. You want to have a say. The last 20 years of Hougang is history. The history is important. Hougang people appreciate their history. Hougang residents love their history. And we should not forget our history. But the next 20 years belongs to the youth. And I fully intend to make sure that they shape what Hougang is going to be like for the next 20 years. Choose the person who best represents your values and your hopes. Choose the person who has already demonstrated the commitment to you. From the bottom of my heart, to all of you today, you have become an integral part of my life. Sometimes my wife says that Hougang is, you spend more time in Hougang than at home. I will try to make sure they have good work-life balance. But truly, Hougang is my family. I've come to understand, to humbly serve, and to contribute. To my Hougang family, I have, I am, and will always be here for you. I will put my heart and soul, and I will serve you better. Vote for me and for a brighter future for Hougang. Thank you so much. Thank you.